light has come into the world. Not to condemn, but to save. For he so loved the world, his very life he gave. Light has come in. Condemned even still, if we're choosing darkness instead of the light. Of the light. His grace is
found within. I never knew the meaning of joy down in my soul. When at last I finally knelt, contentment filled my soul like it never felt. Heaven came down, there was glory all around when he filled my soul. I remember the day when the Lord saved.
When the Lord saved me,
all of heaven came down.
All of heaven came down.
I was happy and free.
I was happy and free.
Glory filled my soul.
Glory filled my soul.
For I knew the Lord had made me whole. I shall never forget the day when the Lord saved me. Now a life of peacefulness deep within my heart.
The day that Jesus took my sins away,
and to heaven I will go, spend the endless ages while they ever roll, praising his name for the glorious day when he saved my soul.
Hey, Brother Tim.
I remember the day.
I remember the day
when the Lord saved me.
When the Lord saved me.
All of heaven came down.
All of heaven came down.
I was happy and free.
I was happy and free.
Glory filled my soul.
Glory filled my soul.
For I knew the Lord had made me whole. I shall never forget
the day
when the Lord saved me. I shall never forget.
When the Lord saved me.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise.
Amen.
Jesus. No, it's so wonderful to know who Jesus is. It's so wonderful to abide in the vine.
Amen.
To abide in the living God, the God of the Bible, Jesus Christ, the way, the truth, the life. No man comes unto the Father except by him. I know him. I've had an encounter with God. I had an encounter with Jesus Christ. I repented of my sin. I put my trust and faith in Christ. I was a drunkard. I was a fornicator. I was a pot smoker. I was puffing out cigarettes 2 packs a day. And one night I got tired. I got tired of being miserable. I knew I was a hell-bound sinner. I repented of my sin. I cried out to God. I said, God, have mercy on me, a sinner. Please, Lord Jesus, save my soul. And you know what happened? In a moment in time, in the twinkle of an eye, in the snap of a finger, Jesus Christ came into my life and he set me free. And we're out here tonight because we want you to know what that's like. We want you to know what that experience is like to become a new creation in Christ Jesus. To be set free from the captivity of sin. To be set free from the bondage of sin. To know who the Lord is and what His Word said. Oh, Jesus said you are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid, but is set on a candlestick. And it giveth light unto all that are in the house. You're here at the Edison Parade tonight. Thomas Edison, he invented a light bulb. He invented a light bulb, but I know the man who invented light.
Amen.
I know the creator of light. I know the light of the world. And His name is glorious. His name is wonderful. His name is everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, the great I Am, wonderful Counselor, the Almighty God. His name is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And it says in Acts chapter 4 and verse 12, for there is no salvation in any other, for there is none other name given under heaven. Under heaven, given among men, whereby we must be saved. That's the name of Jesus. That's the name you call upon
when you're broken. Shut him off.
That's the name you're tired when you're tired of sin. When you're tired of being held down. When you're tired of being under the heavy burden of sin. That is the name that you cry out to, that you call upon. You call upon for deliverance. You call upon Him so He can save you. Because if you're outside of Jesus, if you know not God, you have a giant millstone. A giant millstone of sin. A giant millstone of sin. It's around your neck. It's weighing you down. It's dragging you down. And the end result thereof is hellfire. Unless you repent and believe the gospel. And Jesus Christ came. He came preaching repentance from sin. Repent and repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. For the time is fulfilled. And the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe the gospel. Repent and believe that Christ died according to the scriptures. He was buried and He resurrected again on the third day according to the scriptures.
Amen.
Jesus Christ demonstrated His love for you at the cross. Jesus, God bless you in repentance. Yes, Jesus Christ demonstrated His love for you at the cross. And the problem is we got hard-hearted, stiff-necked, uncircumcised at ears, and hardened heart sinners who hate God and His Word. Why do you hate God? God died for you. Jesus died for you on the cross. And why do you reject His love towards you? His love is the truth of God's Word. That's what we're giving you tonight. We're giving you simply what God's Word says. And God's Word commands you to repent. God, Jesus Christ, the Bible says the Word was made flesh and it dwelt among us and we beheld Him in His glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and of truth. In the beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things are made by Him, and without Him there was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and that life was the light of men, and that light shineth into the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. Comprehend what? You'll comprehend the Word of God. The Word of God is coming nigh unto you. The Bible says the Word of God is nigh unto me. It's close. It's even in my mouth. This is the Word of faith which we preach. And if thou shalt confess the Lord Jesus and believe in thine heart that God hath raised Him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Hallelujah. God came down. He died at the cross for His enemies. Yes, you're an enemy of God if you're in your sin. You're separated from God. You're outside of God. You're outside of Jesus Christ, separated. And you need to be reconciled. And that's the whole point of the cross. That's the whole point of the sacrifice. That's the whole point of it coming down in the flesh, Jesus, manifesting himself in the flesh. Okay, coming down, living a perfect life, a sinless life. He was beaten, he was bruised, he was scourged, he was busted open wide. He had stabbed in the ribs with a spear. He had a crown of thorns plated upon his head. He got smashed in the face with a reed. He was buffeted. He was buffeted, he was bruised for all of you people. But you people reject him when you continue in your sin. You reject the sacrifice on the cross when you continue in your sin, when you continue in your rebellion, when you continue in your darkness, when you continue blinded by Satan, or you're blinded by the power of Satan. Awake unto righteousness and sin not, for some have not the knowledge of God. And I speak this unto your shame. I speak it unto your shame. You know not God, and you obey not the gospel. But I'm here tonight that you might know who God is and what God demands of you. He demands repentance. Oh, are you tired of sin yet? Are you tired of living a meaningless life? You know, think about tonight. Think about who you are as a person tonight. Think about who you truly are as a person tonight. What is your identity? What's your identity? Where do you stand in the sight of God tonight? Most of you people will say you're all right with God, but you're truly not. Because the Bible says, be ye not conformed into this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. The Bible says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that's in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the pride of life, it's not of the Father, but it's of this world. And the world is passing away in the lust thereof. But he that does the will of God, he that does the will of God, does it, abideth forever. Oh, do you want to abide forever? Do you know? Want to know what an experience is like to know who Jesus truly is? To be born again? To be set free? To not have a care in the world? Jesus said in Matthew chapter 11, verses 28 through 30, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly at heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Oh, we know Christ, the yoke is easy, his burden is light. There's peace, there's joy. Your joy is a fabrication of joy. You don't have true joy. That's why you go from festival to festival and it never satisfies you. You go from beer to beer, cigarette to cigarette, and it never satisfies you. I'm here to tell you about the living water. I'm here to tell you about everlasting water. Through the blood of Jesus Christ, through the sacrifice on the cross, for he was wounded for our transgressions, and he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes, people, with his stripes, with the sacrifice, you can be healed. You gotta be willing, you gotta be obedient, you gotta be tired, you gotta call upon the Lord, you gotta forsake your way. The Bible says, submit yourself therefore to God, resist the devil, and he shall flee from you. Draw nigh to God, and he will draw nigh unto you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners. Purify your hearts, you double-minded. Be afflicted and mourn and weep. Be afflicted and mourn and weep. But your laughter turn to mourning, and your joy unto heaviness. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up. Seek the Lord while he may be found, and call you upon him. Woe is me. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thought. Let him return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. You see, Christ can pardon you from sin. Christ can set you free from sin. Christ can make you a new creature. Christ can make you a new person in a moment in time. But you gotta submit. You gotta be humble. You people can't come to Christ. Pride. pridefully. Because the Bible says pride goeth before destruction, a haughty spirit before the fall. The Bible says that God resists the proud, but he gives grace unto the humble. Humble yourself. Come to God. Come to God. Come to the Lord. Come to the living water. You know, repent of your filthy communication. You're cussing, and there are all these kids here, you're cussing out your mouth. And you call yourself a Christian. It's wicked. It's ungodly. The Bible says repent. Repent. Repent therefore. Be ye converted. That's your sin. May be blotted out. When the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. Oh yes. The Bible says, unto us God, having raised up his Son, sent him to bless you. He sent him to bless you. In turning away every single one of you. God sent his Son to bless you. In turning away every single one of you from your iniquity. Only the power of Jesus Christ can turn you away from sin. But you have to put full trust. You have to believe on him. You have to believe on what Christ Jesus did for you. And you have to come to grips with who you really are. Because most of you are self-serving. Most of you are selfish. Most of you love sin. Most of you love pleasure. Most of you love entertainment. You take all the things that you love and you set that on a candlestick instead of the things of God. And that's your idol. That's your worship. That's who you serve. But I serve a risen Savior. And his name is Jesus. And I want you to know who Jesus truly is. Because there's a figment of imagination going on in America of who Jesus really is. And Jesus commanded all men everywhere to repent, because he has appointed a day in which he will judge the world in righteousness. He's not going to judge you in how many beers you can drink. He's not going to judge you in how many TV shows you watch this week. He's not going to judge you on how many concerts you attended. He's not going to judge you on what kind of clothes you wear. He's not going to judge you on what your bank account looks like. He's going to judge you according to his word. And the problem is, America, you're not ready. You're not ready to stand before God. You're not ready to give an account. You're not ready to stand before the... You're not ready to take your last breath and go into eternity. Well, the Bible says in Hebrews 9:27, it's appointed a man once to die. After this comes the judgment. You're going to draw your last breath. You're going to die. There's no stopping death. You're going to die. And you need Jesus Christ. Because you need to keep hearing it, sir. Because Jesus Christ is calling you to repentance tonight. He can take that foul mouth and he can make it clean. Oh, I used to cuss like a sailor. But when Jesus Christ saved me, I speak wholesome words now. Amen. That's true repentance. That's true deliverance. I used to be a drunkard. When Jesus Christ saved me, I don't want to drink anymore. I've been set free from it. I used to smoke 2 packs a day. Jesus Christ set me free from it in a moment in time. That's the power of God. Not this fake power of God that you see in your church today. This lip-wristed pastor getting up there telling you lies, deceiving you. The Bible says in the last days, perilous times shall come. During the last days, and guess what, America? Perilous times have come. Men shall be lovers of self rather than lovers of God. You people love yourselves more than you love God. And the Bible says, the wicked shall be turned into hell, and every nation that forgets God. You've forgotten God. You turn your back on God. I'm calling you to repentance tonight, because I love my neighbor as myself. I care about you people. I know there's a judgment day. I know there's a hellfire. And I know if you don't repent and believe the gospel, you're going to end up there. You're going to end up there. The Bible talks about it in Mark chapter number 9, where the worm dieth not and the fire is never quenched. If your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. For it be better for you to enter the kingdom of God than have 2 eyes cast into hellfire, where the worm dieth not and the fire is never quenched. If your hand causes you to offend, cut it off. For it be better for you to enter maimed in the life than end up where the fire shall never be quenched. Where the worm dieth not, the fire is never quenched. If your foot causes you to offend, if your foot led you here to sin tonight, Jesus has something for you. He said, cut it off. Cast it from me. cut it off and cast it from thee. It'd be better for you to enter into life halt than enter into hell fire, where the worm dieth not and the fire is never quenched. The fire's unquenchable. The fire won't be quenched. And the Bible says that sinners who die in their sins will end up in the lake of fire. The Bible says, whosoever's name was not found written in the book of life shall be cast into the lake of fire. The Bible says, he who sins is a servant to sin, and a servant abideth not in the house forever, but a son abideth ever. Therefore, if the Son Jesus Christ, if the Lord Jesus Christ shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed. Do you want to be free? Do you want to be made new? Do you want to be washed in the blood? Do you want to be forgiven? Isn't that what it's about? Don't you want to be forgiven? Don't you want to be forgiven for your rebellion? You know, the Bible says that the law of God is written on your heart. You have a moral compass because God gave it to you. God's the one that gave you that moral compass. That's why you know not to steal. That's why you know not to cheat. That's why you know not to fornicate. That's why you know not to lie. That's why you know not to be a drunkard. That's why you know not to have filthy things come out of your mouth. That's why you know you shouldn't look at these immodestly dressed women here. That's why you know those things are wrong. You know these things are wrong because God wrote it on your heart. And you can't help it. But I'll tell you one that can help you. I know a physician. I know a physician. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus Christ said, they that are whole need not a physician, but they that are sick. I came not to call the righteous, but listen up, people. Jesus Christ said, I came to call sinners to repentance. Oh, John the Baptist, a voice crying in the wilderness said, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Make this path straight. Make this path straight. Every valley shall be filled. Every mountain and hill shall be brought low. And the crooked way shall be made straight. And the rough way shall be made smooth. And salvation will come to all flesh. It's available for all flesh. Salvation is for all people. That's what it goes on to say. John the Baptist said, oh, ye generation of vipers, who hath warned you to flee? Who warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bring forth therefore fruits worthy for repentance. And think not to say unto ourselves, we have Abraham as our father. For I say unto you that God is able of these stones to raise up children. He's able to raise up children unto Abraham. That's anybody. He's able to raise up children unto Abraham. And now the axe is laid unto the root of the tree. And every tree that bringeth forth not good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. What is the tree he's talking about? That's unrepentant sinner. We don't repent. The axe will be laid to the root of the tree. Every tree that bringeth forth not good fruit will be hewn down and cast into the fire. Jesus Christ, whose fan is thoroughly, his fan is in his hand, and he will thoroughly purge his floor. And he will gather the wheat into the garner, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. With unquenchable fire, friends. Jesus Christ said, ask and it shall be given you. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh, receive it. And everyone that seeketh, find it. And everyone that knocketh, it shall be opened. It goes on to say in verse 13, Matthew chapter 7, enter ye in at the straight gate. For wide is the gate, broad is the way. Broad is the way that leadeth unto destruction, and many there be which go in therein, because straight is the gate, narrow is the way that leadeth unto life. Few there be that find it. Few there be that find it. Jesus Christ said, if you shall confess me before men, I will confess you before my Father which is heaven. If you shall deny me before men, I will deny you before my Father which is in heaven. Listen up. Think that I came not to send peace on earth, Jesus said. I came not to send peace but a sword. I came to set at variance a man against his father, a mother against her daughter, a mother-in-law against her daughter-in-law, and a man's foe shall be damned his own household. And he that loves mother or father more than me is not worthy of me. And he that loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh up not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me. He who finds his life shall lose it. He who loses his life for my sake, Jesus said, the same shall find it. He that receives you receives me, and he that receives me receives him that sent me. The Son of Man, Jesus Christ, came to save that which was lost. If you're lost tonight, if you're on the broad path that leads to destruction, Jesus is calling you to himself. Jesus is calling you to repentance. Jesus is calling you to the cross tonight. You can have it forgiven all in a moment in time if you would just confess. If you would just forsake it, forsake your sin, confess to the Lord. Confess to the Lord with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength that you need a Savior, that you need to be saved. And God, if your heart is pure before God and you really mean it, God will save you. So in the name of Jesus Christ,